Welcome to the Gawk at the Savage Primitive Show, where we take a being from a Class Zero civilization and bring them to our world. I'm Falel, and I'll be your host. The three-headed being waved his tentacles at the camera. We're switching gear from the hoof slimes in the last episode. Today, we'll be interviewing a human. The audience clicked with appreciation as the curtains drew back, revealing the aforementioned human. It looked around and tugged at the helmet harness that covered most of its body. Hello, human. You've been given the incredible opportunity to meet advanced civilization. Are you excited? The host stuck a microphone in front of the inferior species. The human blinked. I've been abducted by aliens? It said calmly. The human pulled again at the contraption containing it. What, is this a translator or something? Yes to both. Falel winked at the crowd, who tittered. We're going to show you some scenes from our civilization, and we want your honest, unfiltered opinion. Understood? Alright, I've been needing a vacation anyway. Its face scrunched oddly as two workers wheeled in the enormous screen. The bulky device crackled as the technicians began the sequence to power it up. Now human, I want to warn you that what you see isn't currently happening. It's happened before, but the moving images are simply— A recording? Interrupted the human. Yeah, I know. It made a garbled noise and frowned. The translator beeped as it categorized the new word, and the human spoke again. That's a television, right? Even if it is a little big? Falel clicked, low and slow. You know what it is? The host turned to the audience and made two shocked faces. Well, humans are certainly different from the slimes. They fell apart at this part of the show. He paused as everyone groaned. And started worshipping the television. Okay then. Baring its blunt teeth, the human leaned back in its chair. Or tried to, since the translator restricted movement. Show me what you've got. The screen displayed tall, amorphous buildings, and streets with thousands of beings in cars. The hustle of city life blared through the large speakers. We live here, said Falel, two heads watching carefully for the human's reaction. All of us stacked on top of each other in these buildings. The human's face scrunched again. That's nice. Indeed, Falel seemed rather disappointed by the human's lack of reaction. Here's something not so nice. The host waved three tentacles and the screen changed. The virtual grainy being screamed as bullets tore through them, but the flash and thunder of bombs soon silenced them. The bloodiest battle from the Ariri-Varori War, the host said, ducking its head. Thousands dead in a matter of minutes. I'm sure your world has nothing like such carnage. The audience clicked in agreement as Falel turned to face them. Ah, modern civilization can be so horrible. Communicating with primitive civilizations reminds us of a better time. It is tragic, agreed the human. War always is. It showed its teeth again, but in a different manner from before. Unfortunately, we're no strangers to war on that scale. All of Falel's heads blinked. Really? Yes, guns, bombs, professional armies. We have those. The human gestured at the device. We have TV, too, as well as skyscrapers, cars, and cities. The image flickered and the technician kicked the enormous device. You do. The host waved his tentacle twice, and the other technician brought forth a wired metal box. How about instantaneous communication? If you speak into this metal device, you can communicate with beings on the other side of the planet. Phones? Yeah, we've got them. I have mine with me, actually. It opened the flap on its clothing and pulled out a tiny rectangular gadget. Falel and the audience clicked and groaned. You must be joking, human. That contraption's much too small for any sort of communication. The host shook his head. No, I'm serious. It tapped the device and light poured from the screen. Everyone, especially the technician, made a high-pitched squeak. But it can do more than just call. The human used its digits to display images of its own cities and people. The buildings were rectangular instead of rounded, and the streets were filled with humans. But the scene looked remarkably similar to the one that had been on the television. The human tapped the screen again and noise blared out to accompany the video of the human cities. It continued. My phone can play videos, take pictures, and even browse the— At this point, the human made a garbled noise. The translator beeped. The human croaked again and frowned. I guess you don't have a word for it. A word for what? Managed Falel. Though the host, and everyone else, was still entranced by the miraculous gadget. For a, system that allows computers to exchange information, I guess. It wiggled in its harness. The is used to instantaneously access pretty much anything. Music, video games, you can even call people or them. With visible difficulty, Falel waved several tentacles. We must have made a mistake. Humans can't be a class zero civilization. Either they were classified wrong or we read it incorrectly. How do you classify civilization? Asked the human. Well, class zero civilizations have no presence outside their home planet. Class one civilizations have colonies inside their solar system. Class two planets have colonies outside of it. And class three civilizations have faster than light travel. Philel clicked once. But with your technology, your species must be a class two at the very least. The human made a strange wheezing noise as it rubbed its head. Actually, your classification isn't wrong. We don't have any real presence outside of our planet. Philel waited for the shocked cacophony of clicks to die. That certainly is unexpected. How did that happen? How did your people invent such astounding creations while having minimal space flight? The human squirmed again. I guess we just had other priorities. Philel's three sets of eyes focused on the human. Your species had priorities besides space travel. The human made a wheezing noise again and held up the device. Yeah, I guess. See? Two of the host's eyes blinked. I do see. We were going to erase your memory before sending you back to your planet. The host's three heads eyed the human's phone. However, I'm sure we can come to an agreement. The human revealed its teeth again. I'm sure we can. And thus, humans remain one of the few species to jump from class zero to class three. However, humans seem to be much prouder of their other, more unique achievement. They remain the only species whose first contact happened as a result of reality TV.